let us discuss about power consumed by a group of resistances. Like say we are given with a circuit in which we are given with a group of several resistances, and across terminals A and B it is connected across a battery of EMF V. Now in this situation, say the battery supplies a current I. In this situation, we can directly write current supplied by battery. This can be written as I is equals to V by R equivalent, if R equivalent is the equivalent resistance for the group of resistances. And in this situation, if we calculate the power consumed by the group, then this can be directly written as P is equals to I square R equivalent, because the whole group is equivalent to a single resistance of value REQ. So this will be I square REQ. In this situation, if we substitute the value of I, this will be given as V square by REQ. We can use either I square R or V square by R, a relation for a group of resistances. Or even if there is a single resistance, we can use this relation. But if we wish to calculate the power consumed by the individual resistance in the group, we need to calculate the current in each branch of the circuit or the group. And for individual resistance, we can calculate it. And finally, the overall power which we are calculating by this method will be given by the sum of I square Ri, where I is equals to 1 to n, I is varying from 1 to n. This is basically for n resistances in the group. Say if n resistances are connected in the group, if you calculate the current flowing through the individual resistances of the group and calculate the individual power consumed by each resistance, that is I square R, I square R, and sum it up, the final result will be given by the same relation which we are calculating here. And this method can also be used sometime to calculate the resistance of a group or an individual resistance also. Like sometimes, so we are given with lamp ratings. This is also a very useful concept to be understood. Like say we are given with a lamp which is of power 100 watt at 200 volt. That means this is a lamp which consumes 100 watt at the potential difference of 200 volt. Even if you have a look on different lamps in your domestic circuits, you will see that on each lamp there are two parameters written. One is the power consumption and other is the proper voltage rating. It gives us an idea that when the lamp is applied 200 volt potential difference, then it consumes 100 watt power. So in this situation, we can say for this P is equals to I square R, or it can be written as V square by R for this particular lamp. Then we can calculate the resistance of lamp by using this power rating as R is equals to V square by P. So for this lamp, it can be given as V square is 200 square divided by power as 100 watts. So on simplifying, we'll get it 400 ohms. That will be the resistance of this lamp. So using this resistance, whenever a current I flows through it, you can calculate its power as I square R. Or both of these relation, I square R or V square R, we can calculate for calculation of power consumption of individual resistance or even for a group of resistance.